So I'm going to say, in this case, we connected it in parallel. So ammeter goes in series, but the resistor goes in parallel. Whereas in this case, if I had a resistor, external circuit, right? Voltmeter are usually connected in parallel or series? Parallel. Which means your galvanometer is supposed to go in parallel. Here, inside the galvanometer, it was in parallel. Whereas here, inside the galvanometer, the resistor is going to be in series. That's all. So if you know this, you will not make the mistake. Okay. So this is again RG. This is RV. Why RV? This is resistance for the ammeter. That's the resistance for voltmeter. So this entire bunch will be called as ammeter. This entire bunch will be called as voltmeter. So the principle is exactly same. So I am going to be flowing some current I. Here, one thing I forgot to tell you here is the resistance should be as low as possible. Okay, only then it can bypass more current, right? Which means instead of flowing the current this way, it will be flowing, most of the current will be flowing this way, so that this equipment will be saved. So you should say the resistance as low. I should not say resistance is very low to make the current bypass. Which means you don't want to flow too much current through the galvanometer, right? Now come to this. So here what we say is, I want to measure the voltage across this AB. So I am going to flow only IG current. You see, the galvanometer should not take more than IG value, right? If it takes more than this value, it's going to be damaged, which means I don't want that to happen. Which means only IG will be flowing through this. So the remaining is going to be flowing through this one. So I minus IG is going to flow through this. However, in this case, we are interested in the voltage across this point. So how can I calculate the voltage across this point through this? I know the current flowing through this. So voltage across AB can be written as IG into RG plus RV. Why? Series connection, right? Are you folks understanding this? Because even though I am not showing the resistor here, it means the galvanometer has got a coil, which means the coil has got a resistance. That value is what is called RG. Okay. So IG is equal to RG plus RV. That's all. So we can say the voltage across this VAB is equal to IG RG plus RV. So let's try to understand this better. So this voltage V is equal to IG RG plus RV. This is the maximum voltage you want to measure. Maximum voltage that needs to be measured. What is IG? Maximum current galvanometer can take safely. What is RG? Resistance of galvanometer. What is RV? RV. That's the resistance which we are supposed to find. So if I want to measure this much voltage, maximum voltage, what is the resistance I am going to connect? Okay. As we do some problems, it will make more sense, but this is the theory behind converting galvanometer to ammeter and voltmeter. Okay. So RV is the resistance that should be connected. Should be connected across galvanometer in series. So here, if I want to write it as a simple way to remember, ammeter is equal to galvanometer plus low resistance. In series or parallel?
Parallel.
Here I am going to say voltmeter can be obtained from galvanometer plus, is actually, you know, as we do some problems, it will make more sense. So if I put very low resistance here, right, then I will be flowing lot of current, which means it's not good for this one. So I will be increasing the resistance here. So if I increase the resistance here, the current flowing through this will be restricted. Okay. So I will say high resistance connected in series or parallel? Series. That's all. Okay. So you see, in both the cases, what we did was simply found the voltage across this and this, then we equated it. In this case, we simply said the voltage across this can be found as IG into RG plus RV, as simple as that. Anything difficult here? Okay. So here everything is easy, but once you come to the test, everything is difficult. This time no issue. You can calibrate. For example, in this case, if I want to measure, say, 10 volt, right? Say, for example, let me explain it like this. So in this case, right, if you see the label here, it goes from 0 to 3 volt, right? Everyone listen, please. So you have a resistor here and it goes from 0 to 3 volt. If I use this, right, and if I calculate this for 3 volt, right, and then if I know the IG, I can calculate the resistor of this one and I can check whether they have used the correct one. But if the same voltmeter, right, if I want to use it for 10 volt, what should I do? I can't use it this one, but what is the modification I should do? Change the resistor, right?